And you lift your heart, lift palm, and then begin to take a little bit of a rotation. Take the left shoulder towards the ear, and then peel it down the back, and sort of peel it open there. And then tuck your chin a little more, and you can turn your head. Yeah, keep breathing. Good, enjoy the raindrops. This very wet winter day. And then exhale, release back to front and center. Good job. That was awesome. Okay, so now let's do a little bit of work for the heart and chest opening. So take the shoulders towards the ears and then down the back. And then your hands could just take a hold of the chair there. Good. So you're really lifting your heart. Good. Really sit tall. Send your tailbone down there. Good. Nice. Can you move your elbows towards one another a little bit? There. Good. Move your head a little from side to side. Good. Tuck your chin. Now really tuck your chin a lot. Good. And now take your skull back towards the wall and lift your chin. That's a lot. Okay. Just breathe. And then exhale, release. Woo! Good one. So you're protecting your cervical vertebrae. Like, we don't want to just lift our head like this suddenly because, you know, that brings like a crunching action to the cervical. But if we do this action of doing this first, we lengthen those muscles and then we take it back like that, okay? So this pose that we're doing today is called camel pose. And I'm not really sure the deeper significance of that. I have yet to really see how it resembles a camel, but it is, it's getting a back bend into your thoracic region there. So let's do that one more time. Ustrasana. Say us.
Bruce.
It sounds like Bruce, but without the B, just U-S. Us. Right. Ustrasana.
Ustrasana.
All right, let's say it five times. Ustrasana. 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 Okay, all right. Ustrasana, it means camel pose. Okay, so shoulders towards the ears, and then we roll them down the back. So we're really lifting the heart. Good. You can take a hold of the chair there. That's good. Really send your tail down. Tuck your chin. And then take your skull back and lift your face just a little. And breathe fully, deeply. Really feel the breath opening and moving into your abdomen. Take one more full breath. And now keep taking the back of your skull towards the wall behind you, but tuck your chin. And then slide it down your chest and then release. Good. Yeah, so it's like you have this very special movement of your head. And you all did that really well. It's kind of a sliding movement. Good. Okay. Let's do this backwards and forth movement again, like we're walking. Just like you're walking in place. So your opposite hand goes forward and your knees shift a little forward. Yeah, good. Pull back and then start to get a little bit of a twist, kind of a sachet movement. Good. And now start to lift the arms a little bit more like you're really starting to swing. Yeah, so your hands come forward. Good. Good. Okay, and I think everybody here has pretty good mobility in their shoulders. So let's start to actually do this swimming. But at the same time, can you do that thing with your legs? You know, coming forward. And then, so you're doing a little bit of a twist with your feet and your knees, too. Good. Good. One more time. Really take the shoulder blade back. Each time, good. 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 And then just bring it to a stop. Wow. Good job. All right. That's great. So you're, you know, this is a little bit more lively movements of the joints and glands series there. So we did our massage, our Abhyanga. We're kind of warming up the spine like this. Good. So we did Ustrasana, the camel pose. And let us work with our legs and our feet now. So sitting tall, float up the right leg. And you can hold it with your hand if you Make some circles with the foot about the ankle. Yeah, this is a cranking movement. And then point the toe and circle from the toe to the knee, like you're making an ellipse there. Yeah, you can hold your knee in point. And then make the bicycling movements, and I like to close the joint a little bit more so that I bring pressure, and even just a little pressure on the, yeah, great, good job.
Press whenever you need to.
Yeah, and then take it to the side, and you know,
pull my neck.
Yeah, just a little bit is good. Just keep trying. Just a little bit is good. And, you know, you're just bringing it up so it brings into the belly there, and then reverse that direction.
Does it hurt a little bit?
It can. As long as it's not a shooting pain, you know. It's just like there's a lot of stuff going on there, you know. So rest. You don't want to do it so that it hurts, you know. So just a little tiny bit, and then coming straight back. And again, you can compress this as you come straight back. Push.
I can't get enough like here.
That's okay. Just a little bit is good. Push. I'm doing it for you. Push.
Okay. I'm good.
All right. Now, seriously, if you're looking at me doing it, you are getting the benefits as well. Even if you just do a little bit, I promise you, that's the way the tradition works. It's the teacher does the work for you. It's called an auspicious boon. And, you know, my teacher did it for me. My teacher always said, don't worry, I'll do it for you. And of course, students are always very lazy, right? Oh, you'll do it? Okay, fine. I'll just watch you do it, you know. But that's the thing, that teachers are totally committed, even more than a mother, to bringing healthfulness to the student. Okay, so just a little bit is good, but even just looking with your eyes, the eyes are everything. Okay, alright, so then we extend the leg and we stretch the front side of the leg, you know, just like good, and then we stretch the back side, and then we stretch the front side, stretch the back side, good. Okay, make a fist, or turn it into a little ball down there. Good, and then spread the toes. Good, good, make a little ball. Tight. Squeeze all the fluid out of the pores, and then, good, okay, turn the sole towards the patio. That way, good, and then towards the salon. Good, towards the patio, towards the salon. Good, it'll make you warm. And then put your big toe down. Watch out for the chair leg. Build up a charge, and then, quickly. Yeah. Wow, you guys are so fast. That's great. Good. And then give it a little pat down. And the other day we did a full massage on the leg. So hopefully you remember that. You use your smirk feet to remember to do that massage. And today we're just going over the larger movements. Okay. All right. Set that leg aside. Set it nice and tall and pick up the other leg. Again, you can hold it while you make some circles about the ankle with the foot. Both directions, good. Point the toe directionally. You're making kind of like a cone shape. You're cranking around. Good. Nice, good. And then a little bit of this bicycling. And now you're, if you can, you know, bring a little contraction into the tummy there on your left side, just bring a little compression there. Good, and then out to the side and crossing over. Good, nice, very good. Just getting into the hip joint there and reverse that direction. Good, good, and then straight back. Rest whenever you need to. And then extend that leg. Good. Keep it. That's okay. You guys are good. And then stretch the front side of the leg, like just like a big rolling pin. And then the other side, stretch. And front side. And then the other side. Yeah, so your front side, back side of the leg. Good. Make a fist with the toes. Really make it tight. Good. And then extend the toes. Make it tight. salt, purge the salon, purge the patio, purge the salon, purge the patio. Good. Big toe goes down. Keep your heel up. And in a moment, be mindful of your leg. Build up a charge and then a quick, very quick.
You want to do that too?
That's right. That's a special type of yoga. It's called Sneeze Awesome.
Oh.
Okay. All right. You can give a nice pat down that way. And oh my gosh, we are just zooming through the time here. So that's good. So we are we're at the point where we can do our last little bits here. We work from the head down to the toe. Explore some new twist movements today. So now take your awareness into your left leg and cross it over your right. Very good. And take your right hand, the back of your right hand, to the outside of your left knee there and clasp your hands. Good. All right, so it's very comfortable like this. Sit, yeah, sit tall. You know, so really sit tall and you'll feel that your belly is pressing on there, right? Okay, good. So we're just gonna leave it pressing there for a minute while we breathe. Good, and now take the left thumb to your left hip crease and left shoulder towards the left ear and then onto the back and lift your heart to the left and tuck your chin in, take your head a little bit to the left. And breathe fully. Let your breath massage your organs. Yeah, relax whenever you need to. Yeah, good. That's good. And exhale, release. Come back to center. Whee! Good job, you guys. That's very nice. Release your legs. So that's another way to bring a little pressure to your abdomen, right? A lot of pressure, you know? It's good. We want to massage the organs here. Okay, so now we have to take the right knee. No, let's see. We just do it like this, right? Yeah. Okay, so right knee over the left. Is that working for everybody? Good. Perfect. Good. And then, good. Got it. Is this going to work? There you go. Yeah, there you go. Okay, good. And then left, back of the left hand to the outside of the right knee there. And then your right hand clasps. Good. And again, you sit up tall. You know, bring your heart. Feel the pressure against your belly there. That's good. Okay, so you're sitting here, and then you take your right thumb to your right hip. Take your right shoulder towards your right ear, and then peel it back, roll it down. Yeah, that's good. You sort of roll it down like this as if to show everybody your heart. And then you tuck your chin and turn your head a little. And breathe fully. You okay there? Did you get a little?
Okay, quiet.
Okay, okay. A little bit of a, did it twinge?
You got hung up.
It
didn't want to move.
Okay, all right. Well, you're doing the right thing. Just massage it there, yeah. Okay, breathe. And then after two or three breaths, exhale, come back to the front. Good. So, uncross your legs. So this, we don't often do the this one. So I'm gonna try to bring it in more often just to give you that pressure to your belly, okay? Like that, and also a little bit of the twist. So move your spine however you naturally feel you'd like to move it, just to kind of relax it. I like to make swirls. Now I can do that with my upper spine, you know, like this, with my heart, and you can too. There's that type of movement, and then there's more in the lower part where you're using your hip. And we did this the other day, you know, like where we spill it forward and then we push it back and we go the other way. Good. All right. So, you know,
Do you get the picture? We're taking the spine from the crown of the head to the tailbone, you know, and it's like a string, and then we're like spinning it, right? And sometimes we spin it like this, and sometimes we spin it like that, and sometimes we go like this and take the ends together, you know, over to the side. You know, see what I'm doing? Like, just taking your spine. In yoga, that's what we want to do, is to really move the spine inside your bones there and get everything all circulating so it gets vitality. So the last thing we should do, always make sure it's part of your practice, is lion pose. So hands on the knees, spread the fingers, spread your toes, sit up nice and tall. Try opening your mouth, stick out your tongue, open your eyes. And that rapid exhalation, pitch forward, let your eyes and your face relax. Then take a little contraction in your pelvic floor, hold that as you inhale to come all the way up. Good, and then the counter pose, you squint your eyes up, squint your lips up towards your nose, squint everything up, nice and squinchy. And release, good. And one more time, the lion pose again. So energize your feet, send the energy down into the earth through the foundation here and feel it come back up. Palms against the knees, spread the fingers energetically. Draw the heart through, send your tail down there, tuck your chin, breathe deeply, and then take a full inhalation and go into the pose. Then relax completely, let your head and your neck release. Take that small contraction in the pelvic floor, come up nice and slow. The whole inhalation brings you back up to the top. Good. Okay, good. And last but not least, bring the big toes together, heels together, knees together as though you're holding a piece of paper, and come up onto your toes. Good. Sit tall. You can take your hands to the chair here if you like. Just pick up your right foot, bring it down, pick up your left. Good. Pick up your right, keep breathing, pick up your left, good, pick up your right, good, pick up your left, good, pick up both. Good, good. Yeah, all right, so you know that yoga is about levitation, right? The yogis, you know, they float in space, you know, see, I'm floating. All right, good job, and that's gonna, you know, again, get some tone to those core muscles there. So, all right, this was Smriti Upasthana. Smriti, let me hear you say
Smriti.
Smriti, that's great. Smriti, like a smear, you know, on a bagel. Smriti. Smriti.